Hi, I'm Dan. I'm a staff scientist here at Science North, and today I'd like to talk to you about the Healthy Shoreline Rehabilitation Program. The program is a collaboration between Science North, the City of Sudbury, and the Drinking Water Source Protection Program. Okay, so why did we create this Healthy Shoreline Demonstration Site? As part of the Biodiversity Initiative launched by the City of Greater Sudbury last year, we wanted to show homeowners what could be done to their shorelines to improve them. Improve them in many ways, to prevent erosion, to increase areas for wildlife habitat, and in essence to protect the lake. So what we're doing here is we're creating this buffer zone of native plant material to prevent erosion, to attract wildlife and feed wildlife, and to protect Ramsey Lake, which is after all our source of drinking water. We also want to be able to show this to people who are visiting our site and tell them that if you live on a shoreline, this is probably the best way of taking care of your shoreline so as to preserve our lake and our ecosystem that exists within the lake. What we've done here is we've taken all of the limestone that was here originally and we've reused it so that we can create these planting beds. Initially, what you would have seen here was one barren stretch of beach. We took all the limestones that made up the pass and created all of these beds. And some of the boulders that were here were also incorporated into the site. We've also, of course, planted many, many plants. We have over 1,040 plants that we've put in, and there are 40 different species. We've incorporated everything from shrubs to grasses to perennials to annual plants. Having a large diversity of plants prevents the chance that any insect or disease would damage a large part of the planting. And what it also does is it provides habitat and food and shelter to many, many different types of insects and birds, small mammals, and even their predators. So we've created a pretty large area. And this was only planted in 2009, in the fall of 2009 and the spring of this year. So you can see it's coming in quite well. Another thing that we've used is what's called these sort of gabion walls, this mesh that you see over there. Now that mesh prevents erosion, of course, and we immediately seeded it with grass. And you can tell that the grass is coming in so well that you can hardly see the mesh anymore. So we've got the mesh holding everything up. We've got the recycled stones. We've got the great diversity of plant material. And we have it in several different types of environment. We have some very drought-resistant plants up in this area, and then we have marginal, what are called marginal plants down there, which would be shoreline plants, and then we even have aquatics going into the water area. The larger diversity of plants that you put in an area, the better chances they're going to catch, many of them will catch, and also it'll provide a more diverse environment for the animals and the things that we're trying to protect. An important component of the shoreline rehabilitation are what are called these water logs. These water logs are composed of natural coconut husk and other natural fibers, and eventually these things will decompose, and they are completely organic. Once these decompose, the plants that have been planted here will have established themselves well, developed strong root systems, and take over the role that these were doing in preventing erosion of the soil into the lakes. This signage provides valuable information for homeowners or anybody who really lives on the lakeshore about how to protect the lakeshore, how to protect the lake, the ecosystem as a whole, as far as controlling phosphate runoff, improving animal habitats, and just good practices if you live along the shoreline. If you're at Science North and you're walking along the Ramsey Lake Boardwalk, continue a little bit further, walk on the Science North property, and come and visit the Healthy Shoreline Demonstration Site. There's a lot of information here on the signage that's available to you. And if you would like to, I can be contacted at Science North for any information you may need. I would be happy to share any of that with you. Thank you.